All right, hello and welcome back to my channel, Timeless Kicks. 2021 as of recently has been a great year for sneakers. I recently listened to Complex's podcast about their top 10 sneakers of 2021 so far. So I wanted to give my review on their list and what I think the top 10 sneakers are. So let's get into the video. So at number 10 on their list, they had the Bodega times New Balance 990 V3s. Now I think that this is a perfect place for this shoe. I'm a little bit biased because I love Bodega. I'm from Rhode Island, so I go to Bodega in Boston. It's a great store, I think. The design of it, for one, is really awesome. It's designed to look like a market. It's a hidden sneaker store, so I think that's so cool. And I just love New Balance. New Balance is such a comfortable shoe to wear, so I love what Bodega did on this. I think it really has that classic, like, timeless look. You get kind of like a retro kind of feel to it. You have like a nice brown suede on it, and I think it's just a really great sneaker to commemorate Bodega's 15th anniversary. So I love this sneaker. I definitely think that putting it on number 10 on this list is a great place for it. Next up on the list, we have the Nike Air Max 90 Bacons. Now these re-released in 2021. I believe these came out originally in 2004. And the reason that I like this so much is because this specific sneaker started to really take colorways and materials and use them in a way to tell a story. Now, the story behind this is from Dave's Quality Meat. I love that these came out on Air Max Day, again, because I think that this is such an influential shoe when it first came out for New York City. And I know that this was a certain colorway and silhouette that a lot of people wanted to get their hands on. So it's really cool that they re-released these, and now it's a pretty common sneaker, I'm not gonna lie. You can probably get this in StockX for around retail, a little bit over. Yeah, I also agree with placing this one as number 9. I think it's a great sneaker. Now, number 8 is the Bad Bunny x Adidas Forum Low. Bad Bunny is just a worldwide artist. I love his music. First, he came out with the coffee colorway, and I think that Adidas used the Forum Low because of how popular the Nike Dunks have been this year. So I think that they wanted to compete with the hype surrounding the Dunks, so they used the Forum Low, which is kind of that big, bulky kind of skateboard silhouette. He also came out with an Easter colorway, so it's really bright. It's a really bright pink colorway, which is also kind of cool. But again, I just don't know how I feel and how I would personally rock them. I do know that this particular shoe has a ton of hype surrounding it. For me anyways, I think Yeezy is one of the faces of Adidas, so it's hard to say that it competes with the hype surrounding Yeezy. But I think it's definitely up there. When these released, they had a ton of hype around them. So I think it definitely competes with the Yeezy brand. Number 7, they had the Travis Scott Air Jordan 6 khakis. Love this sneaker so much. Funny story, actually. Was waiting in line to get these, and I had them in my cart. But being a broke college student, I hesitated to actually hit the checkout button, which is so stupid. Like, I had these in my size 8 in my cart ready to just check out, and I didn't end up doing it because I was really nervous about spending the money for him. But Travis Scott has this really specific aesthetic about him, and I think that he exemplified that perfectly in this Air Jordan 6 khaki. It has his, obviously, the khaki colorway, which I think he's pretty much known for. A lot of his clothing, a lot of his sneakers just incorporates this kind of deserty vibe, but it's very different. He has a very different creative aspect when it comes to creating sneakers and streetwear, which I absolutely love. He's coming out with some heat later on this year. I know that he's coming out with another Air Jordan 1 with Fragment. He's coming out with the highs and the lows, which I know are absolutely gonna go crazy. But I think that Travis Scott, as an artist, as a creator, I think that this is an awesome shoe, and I definitely agree with it as at the number 7 spot. Number 6, they have the Adidas Yeezy 450s. I don't think I agree with this one. Personally, for me, I don't know, I just don't really like this sneaker. At the number 6 spot, if I was gonna choose like a Yeezy to put on this list, I probably would have chosen either the slides or the foam runners. The foam runners this year have absolutely gone crazy. People are going crazy for them. I know that they're super comfortable. A lot of people hate on them because they're a hyped up croc, but nonetheless, the Yeezy foam runners have just absolutely taken over. I see a ton of people rocking them. So I don't think that I would have picked the 450 personally. So I don't think that I agree with this number six. Number five, they have the undefeated Nike Kobe Hall of Fame Protros. Definitely agree with this one. When I think about Kobe Bryant, it's still so, like, it just doesn't feel real that he's gone because of the impact that he's had on kids, on adults, on athletes, on women's sports, like just all around how much impact he's had in our culture. The fact that he's gone is just, I still remember that to this day, like just seeing that and just like not knowing how to react. I think that this is a great sneaker. I don't know how I feel about the red accents, but nonetheless, the gold and purple, I absolutely love. I think it's, I really want to get my hands on these just because I think it's a great collector's piece to have, especially because Vanessa, out of the best interest of Kobe, decided to end the deal with Nike. So this is one that I really would like to get my hands on eventually. So I definitely agree with this one as the number five spot. This is one of my favorite drops. The Nike SB Dunk Low What the P-Rod. Oh my gosh. I was so sad that I could not. I entered so many raffles, tried the sneakers app. I tried everything to get these. Couldn't get them. I love Paul Rodriguez. I remember watching his episode on Complex with his sneaker collection. I think that he's just such an OG. I love what he did with this sneaker, just how he meshed all of his like influences and all of his culture into the silhouette. This one personally, I think that you can use as kind of like a savings bond, and something that I've been thinking about paying resale for these now, because these go for around, in my particular size, these go for around $650. But I think that these one day are gonna skyrocket. Will definitely go up in value over time. And like I said, like there's just something about it. A lot of people don't really like Nike's like What the editions. I personally love them because I love just seeing different years all meshed together in one sneaker. I 100% agree with this one as number four. I love the P-Rod so much, and I really, really want to get my hands on these. Number three, they had the Supreme times Nike SB Dunk Lows. Personally, don't agree with this one because, first of all, insanely hard to cop. The amount of times that I like just went into the Supreme app back and on different devices, it was so hard to get. These again, really hyped up. They're going for over $1,000 in some colorways. Some colorways are a little bit lower, but it's a great SB Dunk, don't get me wrong. However, at the number three spot, I don't think I would have put them there. I think I, quite honestly, I would have put just regular Nike Dunk. This has been an absolute year of the dunks. It's crazy for what they're going for. I was able to get the Pandas for retail. They're going now for like $300+, which is crazy for a Dunk Low that retails for $100. I know that the UNCs recently came out, took an L on those, but again, they're reselling for a ton of money. So personally, I would have just put the regular dunks on there. I don't think I would have put the Supreme. Supreme, in my opinion, this year has kind of fallen off. I don't see a lot of the hype that it used to have. I know that Supreme used to go absolutely crazy, and now I see a lot of resellers really struggling. Sell box logos, sell that older stuff that used to have so much hype. People are struggling to resell it. So I think Supreme is falling off a little bit. I don't know what they have in the works, but they'll probably bounce back from it. I think it's just a little bit of a lull right now. And yeah, like I said, I just don't necessarily agree with putting the Supreme Dunks as the number three spot, in my opinion. Number two, huge controversy. They had the Trophy Room time Air Jordan 1. Now, Trophy Room is like a sneaker boutique in Orlando, Florida, and they came out with a collab with the Nike Chicago Air Jordan 1s. This had so much controversy over it because of the backdooring. So to cop a pair of these Trophy Rooms was, I mean, everybody took L's on this. So that's why a lot of people dislike this sneaker. And that's why I personally dislike this sneaker, because it's a great sneaker. It looks like the Chicago is like iced, which is so cool to me. So at the number two spot, in my opinion, I probably would have put the Jordan 1 Hyper Royals or the University Blues, or even the Jordan 4 University Blues. Those three sneakers, and even the white Oreos, those four sneakers have just absolutely killed the market this year. Still so much market for those four colorways. So I would have put one of them at the number two spot instead of the trophy rooms. At the number one spot, they have the Ama Manier Air Jordan 3. 100%, 100% agree with this number one spot. For the first time, women finally got a really, really awesome colorway. Being a female sneakerhead, sometimes the women's sneakers get trash colorways. They're so ugly. I'm sorry, I hate to say it, but they're so, so ugly. So this Jordan 3, it has that really vintage retro vibe with the color blocking because it looks a little bit faded and deteriorated, which I love. I love that it pays homage to a lot of women sneakerheads out there. Yeah, for me, I just think that it's just such a meaningful sneaker and definitely deserves the number one spot. And also just having a lot of men be supportive of this collaboration and supporting the sneaker itself is so monumental. Yeah, that's just my take on Complex's top 10 sneakers of 2021. Let me know in the comments what you think are some sneakers that I possibly missed. And yeah, thank you so much for tuning in, and I will see you guys soon.